Hey guys, Dagan here from PMT of the UK, and this is an IDLES gear guide. And in this video, we'll be covering the guitar sound of Lee Kiernan and Mark Bowen. The guitar guys of IDLES, awesome band, awesome guitar sound. I haven't got their entire rig, because they've got very interesting rigs with many, many pedals and many amplifiers, but I'm here to talk to you about what they use and how you can kind of replicate that with easy stuff off the shelf. If you're watching this video and you're not too sure who IDLES are, they're quite a hard band to describe. Genre-wise, they don't like getting called post-punk or punk or post-hardcore or rock. They're kind of just an entity in themselves. They've been around for a number of years now and are about to drop their third album, Ultra Mono, and it's going to be a sonic masterpiece. So the guitar players, Mark and Bowen. Big Fender guys, huge Fender guys, especially these days. I'm sure they've probably been picked up by Fender because they are rocking the new player series, for the most part, the Strats, the Mustangs, and the Telecasters. Love a bit of the Fender player series, so I'm rocking Fenders today. I'm going to chat about Mark's rig first, and then some of Lee's. I'm going to use the same amp and explain why in those little things, but they do enjoy modifying their guitars. Oh, they really do. And the pedals, like I said, big old pedal boards, and the way they get their sound is essentially, in a nutshell, get an amp with lots of headroom, and stack pedals into it. They're a fan of avant-garde pedals as well. Love a good fuzz, love a good handmade, crazy delay, modulating, sequencing, reverb pedal, and all that kind of stuff. Mix them together and you kind of get the IDLES sound. I've got a layout here on the easiest way you can kind of get that sound in your house without getting any crazy avant-garde pedals. So yeah, running into these, into this Marshall. Let's talk about Bowen's rig first, starting with the guitar. Kind of weird playing some of those lead lines just by themselves, because it's really cool on stage watching Bowen and Lee work together, because they have a good idea of how to layer guitars. Whether one of them's playing rhythm and single lead lines, they've got a really cool way IDLES of playing really unorthodox, simple single note lead lines and making it sound monstrous. It's also helped by the fuzz pedals, which I'll talk about later on, but it's very cool the way the dynamic between the two players work. So the guitars Bowen plays, he loves his 71 Stratocaster almost as much as he loves wandering around in his pants on stage with his mint mustache. He's got a 71 Strat and it's modified and beat to hell, as you can see from pictures from them playing Glastonbury and many, many things like that. So it's been modified in the sense that the volume control is the only control on the guitar body. They kind of only use the bridge pickups, again, which I'll speak about more in Lee's rig, because he's only got the bridge pickup in most of his guitars. One volume, and these are all taken out. Tape over the top of them. I don't know whether they've just been pushed into the body or totally disengaged, because some people say guitars sound better with less happening here, which is kind of true. So I don't know whether these is unsoldered the tone control to get a purer sound from the bridge pickup to the output. Who knows? But anyways, his 71 Strat has been modified to only have one single pickup. And this is the closest guitar I could find at the minute, because I haven't got a 71 Strat, and that is a Fender Vintera Stratocaster 60s. Powfarrow neck, sunburst. It's not a 71, but it's as close as I can get a 70, because Fender don't currently make a 70 Strat that isn't a Squire. So this is a very nice vintage Fender vibe, similar to what Mark plays. And he's been seen playing Strats mainly for a number of years now. Like I say, he's been able to play the Player One, the new amazing Mexican range of guitars, the Buttercream in particular, that lovely kind of yellow. But I've seen interviews recently where, for the new album, coming out very, very soon, he's been rocking the Mustangs with the P90s in. So let's plug that in and see how that sounds. Ultra Mono is apparently dripping in P90 Mustang goodness. I thought I'd plug this one in right now, and it's exactly the same as what Bowen plays. Besides the color, he's got a natural one. This is a lovely shade of green. Same range though, same pickups, and it sounds really good. Lovely kind of mid-range growl from the P90s. It's really, really cool. Now let's go down the signal chain to the effects. It seems to me that Bowen enjoys his crazy effects a bit more than Lee. Lee's got a great sound with his Marshalls, but Bowen enjoys a whole arpeggiated delay, a bit of modulation, and a bit of the old pog. I haven't got any of the crazy, very unique delay pedals those guys have. They're very song specific. I'm trying to talk about an overall sound of IDLES. So the first thing I've got on the chain is the Pog 2, which has been on his board for many, many moons, and you can hear it in the song Grounds after, again, the arpeggiated little intro bit, where again it's fun to talk about how they work together as players. Bowen plays both one note, an arpeggiated delay that goes down in octaves. He plays it affected, Lee just plays it clean. If you want to know the actual notes on it though. But say if having to awkwardly play that with a big old stretch, he's got a nice delay which does it. If you know what delay it is, please comment down below. 12th fret of the high E, 9th fret of the G and the D, ending on the E note, which is the 7th fret of the A string. And that's the intro. The verses is where the pog, actually I'll play it without the pog first to show you how good it sounds with the pog. So very, very simple songs where they manage to manipulate their guitars in such a way to make it sound absolutely beasty. And a pog certainly sounds beastly. Just a great sounding pedal regardless for any kind of lead lines. If you don't know what a pog is, it's an octave generator. So the pog 2, you can go 2 octaves up, 2 octaves down, blend everything together, and there's like harmonizer effects within it. You have probably seen its smaller brother, the regular pog, which just has a couple of knobs on it, but they use the pog 2s. And that's the only kind of crackers effect that I've got for IDLES right now, besides the delay, which I'll talk about at the end. The rest of the signal chain is literally just stacking pedals. The whole ethos of the sound of IDLES is to get an amp with lots of headroom and use pedals to get that gain. Bowen uses high watt amplifiers. I love high watt, but they're very hard to get a hold of in a guitar store. And essentially a high watt, the high watt he uses is a modified plexi. The high watt DR103 is a 100 watt, essentially plexi clone. EL34's one of the best sounding amps in the world. However, it is slightly darker sounding than the plexi and headroom for days. They're known for having headroom for days, whether it be Marshall or high watt. I couldn't get a hold of that because they're quite hard to get, and he's got two of them. So I'm using this Marshall. This is a Marshall JTM 45. Granted, it's not 100 watts, but I'm not very loud right now. I'm nice and quiet in this little room in Newcastle. So quiet, enough headroom for these pedals. And headroom is key, actually. High watts. He's got 2 high watts now because he's in a big band and he can get 2 high watts. Instead of using 1 amp like back in the day with his AC30s, 2 high watts, one for more of the lower register and the other for more of the higher register. So one of them is set up to have the low end, a lot of the growl, and the other is set up to be a bit brighter, a bit more brittle to cut through. And when you mix 2 amps together, you get that epic sound. That epic sound being created with fuzz pedals. The lower bit of fuzz in IDLES, and the first thing usually in their chain is the Katana Boost. The Kili Katana Boost, I can't get a hold of one of them either, unfortunately. My second favorite is the TC Electronic Spark, which is essentially set up as a clean boost, treble and bass, almost at noon. Doesn't really matter for the amount of fuzz that we're using. And that's a boost, whether it be for solos or to stack, which I'm using right now. Into this Acapulco Gold by Earthquaker Devices, which has the biggest knob I've ever seen on it. Look at the size of that. Absolutely crackers. This is a crazy fuzz pedal, which I'll turn on in a bit because it's too intense for a rhythm sound. And this, I thought I'd use the Fender, the Trapper fuzz, because they are big Fender guys these days, and this might make its way onto one of their boards. Great sounding fuzz pedal with 2 fuzzes built in. I'll show you what it sounds like without. That didn't work. There we go. Turn on the Trapper. So it's fuzz into an EL34 amp, but not in the same way that Jimi Hendrix is it. It's a very kind of nasally, rocky kind of fuzz. It's awesome. Again, one of the cool little things I've seen them do live is a lot of the notes, a lot of the songs and lead bits are on the low string. Obviously the high E is an octave of that. So try and hold them both down on the same note, but mute the rest of the strings. Just add a bit more of a sonic flavor. So I've turned the spark off now because I enjoyed the way it kind of sounded clean and distorted, just to show you what it sounds like when it's pushing this. So this is without the spark. I think it's kind of altering it more in the room. Hopefully it's coming across okay on YouTube, because YouTube has got a habit of compressing everything. It's coming through this lovely Aston microphone Stealth as well, I forgot to mention before. Great mic, but hopefully it can pick up the nuance that the Spark is pushing the Trapper Fuzz into a bit more sonic territory, if that makes sense. Now, the Acapulco Gold is absolutely crackers. This is a mental fuzz pedal that Bowen actually uses. Listen how mad it is. It's absolutely mad, and I'm going to show you what it sounds like now without it being stacked against anything else, because it will blow your minds, because it's probably the loudest pedal with one knob I've ever heard, and I've heard some loud one knob pedals in my time. Alex, get ready. The floor's moving, the floor's moving. It's only at 1 o'clock. Let's do a quick 1 of 10, because it's a punk band thing. Ready?
Ready.
There's an office upstairs when I'm filming this, and they're gonna love that. I'm sure they're huge fans of IDLES. That was fun, wasn't it? Let's go down the signal chain now. Something that they don't use. Again, they've got lots of fun pedals, but they are now Fender artists. And the high watts the Bowen uses and the Marshalls, which I'll talk about later, that Lee uses, don't have reverb built in. So I thought, why not use this amazing marine layer reverb by Fender? Again, so I'm not using a lot of reverb. Some of the songs are drenched in reverb, and there's some amazing reverb pedals out there which do that, but they're very unique for specific songs. Just to give a bit of character to the tone, I've got a bit of reverb. And this is a dry. Sounds like a Marshall, very nice. Or a high watt, I should say. Just a little something, something. It's kind of hard to tell when you're giving it big licks. But it definitely adds something, especially to those single note ones. And finally, in this little lineup of pedals to get an IDLES overall sound, I've got a quirky little delay. This is the Earthquaker Devices Space Spiral, and it's crackers. Have a listen. I'll go clean, actually. So you've got a crazy bit of modulation. And IDLES do use delay, but in a very unique way, so I thought this is quite a cool little pedal, and they do love a good bit of Earthquaker Devices in their lineup. So why not hog in the Space Spiral when they want to get really ethereal? So that is the sound of Bowen from IDLES. Very simple setup, and Lee's is pretty much the same. I'm just going to change the guitar because he's a big Telecaster guy. So, guitar, one volume control on both of the guys, to be fair. They've got quite a chaotic stage show, so the less that can go wrong, the better. One volume, all you've got to worry about, just being nice and loud. Into some kind of modulator and boosts. Boosts and fuzzes, they've been known to stack like 5 or 6 fuzzes going into their amplifiers to get their sound. It's awesome, such a cool idea to get an amp with lots of headroom, that is the main thing. Bit of reverb, because the amps don't come with reverb. You can get a bit crazy if you want for some of the tracks, like I was talking about, and a funky old delay at the end. Again, get one with an ascending arpeggio if you want to play grounds properly. But yes, Mustang P90, Stratocasters for Bowen. Let's play some Tellies and Mustangs for Lee. We'll be right back. This is a Fender Player Series Telecaster, and Lee has been a fan of the Tele for many, many moons. Some people think he plays an Esquire because the neck pickup has been taken out of most of his guitars, but it's actually a proper Telecaster with the neck pickup taken out of his guitars, which is essentially an Esquire. Note the lovely shell pink Telecaster the Squire Affinity have put on the wall in honor of Lee's amazing pink Telecaster. He hasn't got a Squire one though, his is a proper Fender. That's just there just for the crack. This is a Player Series. He's been known to rock the Player Series like Lee recently, but he's more akin to the Tele. Different kind of tone to the Strat and the Mustang, obviously. Same scale length as the Strat, so similar kind of feel to play. String through body, which gives it a bit more twang, and the special Telecaster pickups, which also need itself to a lot of twang, which work great with fuzzers because they can poke their way through all the saturation and get a really clean, distorted sound, even with lots of fuzz happening around it. Lee also plays Mustangs. I'll rock that in a second. And he enjoys, one of my favorite guitars he's got is a Buttercream Strat, Player Series Strat, totally modified to have a Strat pickguard with one Mustang pickup in it and one volume control. Super cool to see on a Stratocaster. Anyways, let's play some more sounds with this Tele. Oh, Lee uses Marshall. He actually uses Marshall. He uses JCM 800s into the low input channel. That's why I'm rocking the low input channel on this. Essentially, the JCM 800 is a modified Plexi, so I thought I'd just stick with the Plexi. High watts are modified Plexi, JCM 800 is a modified Plexi. Let's just stick with the JTM. Tell you what's fun that they do. They like to dig in. They really like to dig in. So they use that to their advantage when it comes to songwriting. When you play really hard on the low E string, it goes out of tune, doesn't it? And they have that in their new song Grounds, I think, in the bridge, the middle eight. And because Teles and Strats and Mustangs are made in such a strong way, when you go back to playing a regular E chord, that'll still be nicely in tune, but it adds a fun little dynamic to the playing. This is a Fender Mustang. He loves a good Fender Mustang, does Lee? And note the color. This is the new Fire Mist Gold Mustang in honor of his gold Telecaster. Say I've thought this through. Shell pink and gold, even though they're not the same guitar. I know what I'm doing sometimes. They both love the Mustang, super easy to play, and they've got a very unique sound. Like I was saying, scale length does play a factor. These are only 24 inch scale length, so they're a bit smaller, a bit spankier, it's a bit easier to do bends on, and everything's a bit closer to you because of the scale length, so you can see what you're doing chord-wise a bit easier. And again, due to that chaotic stage show, they're nice to throw around on stage. So it's the same kind of ethos, as I keep saying, Fender guitar into some funky modulation, but most importantly, stack your distortions and fuzzes. There's a great interview with Lee with Marshall where he talks about his JCM 800 and why he loves it. Because of that headroom, he can pile as many overdrives and fuzzes and distortions into that JCM 800, and it's gonna lap them all up for breakfast. So get an amp with a lot of headroom if you wanna get that idle sound, and stack lots of fuzz pedals and distortion pedals. Bit of reverb, bit of funky delay, and you've got it. Bit of aggression, and you're absolutely there. Play some very obscure, simple, single note riffs. Get a looper pedal and you can play with yourself. You can be Bowen and Lee. That'll be a lot of fun. And you can cut a belt in your pants around your living room till you're content enough to then do it on stage. So that's it, guys. A simple video, a simple setup, but a wall of sound for the guitar guys in IDLES. Amazing guitar players that kind of work really well with experimenting and the chemistry they get with their unique riffs and stuff, I will say. Very unique riffs, their use of effects, and their use of stacking pedals into an amp which is designed to distort, almost. It's really cool. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more information on any of the products I've spoke about here today, get yourself to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of all this with a nice filter on. I've been Dagan, and I'm going to listen to some more IDLES and get proper mad. I'll see you guys later.